जय श्री गुरुदेव। गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन। इन प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैव टॉट यू द पोएम नंबर 2 जिप्सी। दिस द पोएम ओनली हैव टू लर्न द पोएम एंड मीनिंग, डोंट हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर एंड चूज द करेक्ट आंसर ऑलरेडी आई सेंड विथ लिंक। टुडे आई विल going to teach you the lesson number 3, unit 5, the concited apple branch, page number 35 in your textbook, unit 5, the concited apple branch. Listen, What do you consider beautiful? What do you consider ugly? Do you treat people who are beautiful and those are not so beautiful differently? Are rich people and poor people treated differently? Hans Christian Andersen talks about such discrimination through the story of an apple branch. He gives the apple branch and the sunbeam personalities and relates them with human behavior. So children, in this lesson, that beautiful and the opposite ugly, these two are differentiate. The author have to show the difference between that an apple branch and the sunbeam personalities, and relates them with human behavior. In human behavior also that differentiate we can see he is showing in this story. So let's start the story. It was the month of May. The wind still blew cold, but from bush and tree, field and flower came the welcome sound. Spring has come. Wildflowers covered the hedges. Under the little apple tree, spring seemed busy, and one of the branches hung fresh and blooming, and covered with delicate pink blossoms that were just ready to open. The branch knew how beautiful it looked. So in this paragraph, May month, the month of May, what is the picture of the nature in the spring season, the author had explained here. In apple tree also, how was the apple tree, under the apple tree, he explained clearly. A nobleman carriage with a countess riding in it stopped in the road. The countess said, "An apple branch is the most lovely object and an emblem of spring." A nobleman carriage with a countess means riding. See, did you see the picture? You can understand. So he also explained about the spring and with the apple tree or apple branch. Turn the page, children. Page number 36. Hearing this, her servants broke an apple tree branch for her. Then they drove to the castle, which had lofty halls and splendid drawing rooms. Pure white curtains fluttered before the open windows, and beautiful flowers stood in shining and transparent vases. There were one vase that looked as if it had been cut out of newly fallen snow. The apple branch was placed along with light twigs of beech. It was a charming sight. Then the branch became proud. So in this paragraph, after came back that servant, the nobleman's servant broke one apple branch, tree branch, and they came back to the castle and they put inside the vase inside after what the situation of the palace rooms, then he explained in that paragraph. Next, people who entered that room praised the flower arrangement and the beauty of the apple branch. Hearing all the praise, the apple branch began to feel very superior. The apple branch felt that some plants like itself and some people are very important due to their beauty, and there are others who are ordinary and mean very little. Now, they start the differentiate of the beauty of apple branch. Poor, despite herbs, said the apple branch, there is really a difference between them and such as I am. There ought to be a difference, otherwise we all would be equal, and that will not be right. So that equality and differentiate that apple branch thinking itself. And the apple branch looked with pity upon them, especially on a certain little flower that is found in fields and in ditches. No one paid much attention to these flowers, as they were too common. They even grew between the paving stones, shooting up everywhere like bad weeds, and they bore the very ugly name of dog flowers or dandelions. So next, the apple branch looked the pity upon the especially one flower, which one almost grow in that some ditches or the stone behind the stones, road stone, that places, and nobody are giving that much importance that one, that name are dandelions. Next, poor despite plants, said the apple bough. It is not your fault that you are so ugly and that you have such an ugly name, but it is with plants as with men. There must be a difference. I am the most beautiful plant in the world, the apple branch would say. So that apple branch was telling itself only about his, it was proud about his beauty. A difference, cried the sunbeam, as he kissed the blooming apple branch and then kissed the yellow dandelion out in the fields. All were brothers, and the sunbeam kissed them. The poor flowers as well as the rich. So, but the sunbeam are not differentiate the apple branch and the dandelions. We are all brothers. And again, the sunbeam kissed both the flowers and apple branch both. Next, the apple bough, like many proud men, and had never thought of the love of God, which does not look at the differences. God loves everyone, and for him there is nothing ugly or beautiful. As he has created them all, the sunbeam, the ray of light, knew better. So we can't tell any difference to each other. It was made by God. It is natural. So nobody can say, I am beautiful and others are ugly. Should not. Everything made by God. It's natural. So you do not see very far, not very clearly, said the sunbeam to the apple branch, which is the despite, despite plant you so especially pity. The dandelion, he replied, no one ever cares for it as they do for me. People walk over the dandelions and crush them. Their flowers are like wool, which fly away and stick to people's clothes. They are weed, and I am very thankful that I am not made like them. But after the dandelions telling, no, people say people are walk by walk only, they are crushed to us with their feet, and after that our flowers are so soft like wool. So it is going to the people's clothes. They're stuck in the people's clothes. A group of children came to play in the field. One of them was so small that he had to be carried. When he was seated among the yellow flowers, he would laugh aloud, blow at them, and kick the roll in the grass while kissing the small yellow flowers in innocence. So some children had played, came to the field, and they are sitting upon the yellow flowers, and they are kissing the yellow flowers, but they doesn't know the difference yet about the dandelions, whatever, applements, nothing. The elder children broke off the flowers with long stems, bent the stalks one round the other to form links, and made first a chain for the neck, then one to go across the shoulder to hang down to the waist, and at last a crown to wear round the head. They all looked splendid in their garlands of green stems and flower, golden flowers. So the which one the elder children, he used to make that all flowers like one by one like links and round one and make a flower garlands and wearing in the neck or head. But the eldest among them gathered the faded flowers carefully on the stem of which was grouped together the seed. But the another one, they are removing the garlands from the flower, when carefully faded, means removing the petals. Turn the page number 30. In the form of a white feathery coronal, these loose, airy wool flowers are very beautiful and look like fine snowy feathers. The children held them to their mouths and tried to blow away the whole coronal with one puff of breath. They had been told by their grandmothers that whoever did so would receive new clothes before the end of the year. The despised flower was by this hope raised to the position of a prophet of foreteller of events. See, now the children are taking that all petals, they are removing from the green faded in down, and they are removing that and they are holding in their hands and they are blowing with breath, and it will flow here and there. There is now they are see the beautiful beautiness of that flower. Do you see, said the sunbeam, do you see the beauty of this flower? Do you see their powers of giving pleasure? Yes, to children, said the apple bog. Then an old woman came into the field and began to dig round the roots of some of the dandelion plants and pulled them up. The sunbeam said, with some of these she will make tea for herself, but the rest she will sell to the chemist and obtain some money. After that, what happened? One old lady had came to the field and she was dig the mud and came out to the roots of the dandelion flowers with plants and pulled them up wholly. After that, sunbeam said, with some she will make the tea, remaining she will sell to the chemist and she can get some money. But beauty is of higher value than all this, said the apple branch. Only the chosen ones can be included in the group of true beauty. There is a difference between plants just as there is a difference between men. So again, the difference between the men and the flower, that apple branch started to tell. The sunbeam tried telling the apple branch that for God everyone is equal. Again that sunbeam telling, but for God everyone are equal. Whatever that apple branch, either the dandelion. That is your opinion. said the Applebug. So Applebug telling that is your opinion. Then some people came into the room. Among them was the young countess, the lady who had placed the Applebug in the sunbeam. The lady who had placed the Applebug in the transparent vase. She carried in her hand something that seemed like a flower. The object was hidden by two or three great leaves, which covered it like a shield, so that no gust of wind could injure it, and it was carried more carefully than the apple branch had ever been. The countess removed the leaves very cautiously to refill the feathery seed, crown of the despised dandelion. This was the weed that the lady had. This was the weed that the lady had so carefully plucked and carried home so safely covered, so that not one of the delicate feathery arrow like petals would blow away. She held the dandelion with care and admiration. She exclaimed, "How wonderfully God has made this little flower. I will paint it with the apple branch together." Everyone admires the beauty of the apple branch, but this humble flower has been gifted by heaven with another kind of loveliness. And although they differ in appearance, both are very beautiful. Then the sunbeam kissed the lowly flower, and he kissed the blooming apple branch, upon whose leaves appeared a rosy blush. So, okay, children. Now, I'll explain. This was the weed that the lady had so carefully plucked and carried home so safely covered. See, she also taking that dandelion flowers with like the petals are there, delicate the feathery arrow petals would be blow away. Which one can blow? She held the dandelions with care, very carefully. She took the dandelions. She explained, and she also explained how wonderfully God has made this flower. Not only that one, I will paint that apple branch together also. So everyone admired the beauty of the apple branch as well as the dandelions. So that kindness, loveliness of that, the different appearances, they are both are very beautiful. Then the sunbeam kissed the lowly flower and kissed the blooming apple branch too, upon whose leaves appeared a rosy blush. So nobody can tell the difference between the beauty and ugliness. Okay, I hope you can understand. Bye, children.